Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Ashwini and today we are going to see the next first PUC computer science lab program. So let me open the program. For that you need to open the Turbo C++ software, double click on it, click on start Turbo C++. So this is the program. So I have already typed and kept it because of time consumption. So it takes lot of time to type. So I have already typed and kept. So let me tell you what is this program. Before that, if you have not subscribed my channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe my channel and please like my video, share it with your friends. And now we are going to see the statement of the program, what you have to do it in the program. So that is what a problem of statement is. So write a C++ program to find the largest, smallest and second largest of three numbers using simple if statement. So the question is clear now. We have to find the largest, smallest and second largest of three numbers. So it's that we are going to give three numbers in our program. Out of this three numbers you need to find largest, smallest and second largest. The condition is you have to use simple if statement. That is the condition, third condition is. So now consider three numbers 2, 3 and 4. So largest is 4, second largest is 3 and smallest is 2, right? 2, 3 and 4. So by this you come to know that which is smallest, which is largest and which is second largest. But when you write it in a program, it is quite difficult to tell. So for that you need to write a set of logic. I'll show you how to write it. First we'll see how to input the data. Then we are going to see the logic. So the first step I told you, you need to add header file. So if you have not watched my previous videos, please go back and watch my previous video. I have told step by step how to write a program. So it is simple if you understand the starting topics. Only then you can understand the next videos. So try to go watch the other videos, then come to a bigger program. So starting we have explained a small program, starting 4-5 videos only small programs are there. It is very easy to understand. So go back, see that video, then come to this video and watch this. So now the first two step will be adding your header files. So first one is iostream.h and the second one is conio.h. So these are the two header files. I have already told why it is used. Iostream.h is used whenever you use cout and cin in your program, you need to add the iostream.h, and whenever you use clrscr as well as getch, you need to add conio.h in your program. So next, void main. Inside this void main you are going to write all the declaration, input, logic, output and you are going to close the braces. That is what you write it in the void main. So first step is declaration. So in the question is itself they have told three numbers, out of three numbers. So three numbers means A, B and C. So we have written this particular statement, int A comma B comma C and a semicolon. If you don't give the semicolon you get an error. So always declaration is data type space variable 1 comma variable 2 comma variable 3 comma up to n number of variables, how much ever you want to declare it, you can declare it. Then at the end you need to give a semicolon. That is how you are going to declare. Next I have declared int largest, smallest and this is second smallest, SEC, second largest it is. So these three variables we have used because in the question itself you can see find the largest, smallest and second largest. So those variables we have declared. So next CLRSCR, we are going to clear the previous output using this CLR SCR function. So next we have a Cout statement. Enter the three numbers, because in the question they have told find the largest, smallest and second smallest of three numbers. So first you need to give the three numbers, then only you can find out which is smallest, which is largest and which is second largest. So for that you have given this first Cout statement, enter the three numbers. So you are going to give C in A, B and C. Till here it takes the three numbers from the user. So next from here actual logic starts. So here you can see till here these if statement, two if statement is used to find the largest, and here this one is used to find the smallest, and this single statement you have, that is to find the second largest. So first we are going to see the how to find the largest. So first you are going to consider you have three numbers A, B and C. So in our logic, first we are considering A is the largest, then you are going to compare the largest with B. If B is largest, we are going to assign largest for B. Then you are going to compare B with C. If C is largest, we are going to consider C as largest. So that is the logic here. So see here, largest is equal to A. We are assuming the first number has largest. So next we are comparing the largest, that is A. We are comparing A with B. If B is greater than the largest, then you are assigning largest is equal to B. Then you are assigning the largest as B. Now B is greater. Again one more variable is left. So again you are going to compare C with the largest. If C is largest, then you are assigning largest is equal to C. At the end of this particular statement, we got the first largest number out of 3. This is the first logic. Next, to consider the smallest one, to get the smallest one, we are going to use these statements. First, you are going to consider A has smallest. So, leave this. This you have found out the largest. So, leave the logic here. Again, this is used for to find the smallest using simple if. You can see if you have a condition and a statement. If you have a condition and a statement, this is simple if. So now again it's like same thing. You have three numbers, you are going to consider A has a smallest number, then you are going to compare A with B. If B is smallest, then smallest number will be assigned with B. Again C you are going to compare with the smallest. Smallest is nothing but B. Then if it is C is smallest, then you are assigning C has a smallest number. So that is what a logic here is. Smallest is equal to A, you are going to consider. Assume the first number has a smallest, that is A. So we are assuming A has smallest. Then we are comparing whether B is less than smallest. If B is less than smallest, then now smallest will be B. Again, this smallest is compared with C. C is less than smallest. If it is true, then it is going to assign the value of C to smallest. Now we have got the largest and smallest. Then to find the second largest, you are going to add all the three numbers minus whatever the largest number and smallest number you have got, you are going to add that and minus with the whole thing. Then you are going to get the second smallest. Lastly, you are going to print the second smallest, the smallest number. See out, smallest number is the variable smallest you have given. Again, endl goes to the next line. Again, you have see out, second largest number is second largest. Again, see out, largest number is largest variable you have given, getch. Getch will wait until you give a key from the keyboard. Till then it will stay in the output screen. So that is what getch is used. So let us see the output now. I'll just first once I'll save it, then I'll go to compile and I'll run successfully. There is no error. Next I'm going to run it. So this is the output screen. Here you are going to enter three numbers first. Let me enter 3, 4 and 5. So now in the first condition you had to find the largest, right? First A will be considered as largest, then A will be compared with B. So whether B is greater than A you are going to check. The condition is true. Now largest will be set to B. Again B has to compared with C. So again whether C is greater than B, that is largest, you are going to check. Yes, C is largest. So now we have got the largest number in the first logic. Again you have the second logic. There you are going to find the smallest, that is 3. Then second largest, you will add all the 3 numbers, that is 3, 4 and 5 you are going to add. So 12 it is, total it is 12. You have got your largest and you have got your smallest. Largest is 5 and smallest is 3. So 8, 12 minus 8 is 4. So you have got the second largest. This is what the logic is. So I'll give an enter key. You can see the cursor is waiting for the key. That is the getch command. So till you give a key, it will stay in the output screen. Once when I press any of the key from the keyboard, it comes to the editor. So this is about the finding largest, smallest and second largest. I hope you understood the logic. I hope you understood how to take the output. So main thing, most of them forget how to give an input for the program. So don't forget that. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit a like, share it with your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.